This week, testimony in the Levi Chavez case zeroed in on the gun, which was found next to Tera Chavez's lifeless body.
Tonight, we take you behind the scenes of APD's crime lab to show you how experts can determine who pulled the trigger. Here's Action 70's reporter Regina Reese.
This is a Glock model 17, 9mm semi-automatic pistol.
A gun similar to Levi Chavez's APD-issued handgun. The weapon he's accused of using to kill his wife, Tera, and making it look like a suicide. APD senior crime scene investigator Carl Ross explains how a gun like this is processed.
On this particular firearm, you've got real rough edges on the grip, also on the trigger, so we're going to swab those areas even though we don't see anything.
This week, Crime Lab DNA expert Alana Williams testified that both Tera and Levi's DNA were on the gun's grip, but it wasn't clear who fired the gun. Detective Ross explains the challenges of trying to get forensics from the trigger.
It's such a small surface, it's very difficult to get fingerprints. So your best bet would be for a blind DNA swab to get somebody's DNA on it.
In the Levi Chavez case, the gun has raised questions about whether or not it was a suicide. The prosecution has focused on testimony that the magazine was unseated when officers arrived.
When it's seated, I mean, you just can't pull it out without depressing the magazine release. By pressing the magazine release, it comes out very easily.
An OMI expert testified Tera would not have been able to press the release after being shot. Right now, there are still weeks of testimony left before the jury decides if the unseated magazine is a smoking gun in the case. Reporting in Albuquerque, Regina Ruiz, Action 7 News.
An expert also testified it was less likely that Tara's DNA from her hand could come up on the gun. It was probably placed on it after she died. And Action 7 News is the best station for complete coverage of the trial. We are live streaming everything from the courtroom at KOAT.com so you can watch it as it happens. And reporter Ana Velasquez is tweeting live updates from the witness stand. You can find that in the main media window.